The Matics hadn't been able to count for as long as they could remember. That didn't really bother them much in their daily lives. Not too much, anyway. Except for the boat Matic, which sank as soon as over 10 people got in it. But come to think of it, that was as good a way as any to count. As soon as they got wet feet, that made 11. It wasn't a very pleasant way of counting, though. So they went to see Max Matic. That was his name because he was the smallest of the bunch. He wasn't short on ideas, though. He also had a gift for music. And sculpture. And he knew a certain professor named Mac One who lived on a hill and who invented machines. Let his machines loose in the woods, where they were free to pursue their favorite machinations. The writing machine wrote letters. The reading machine read happily, even though it couldn't understand anything. The rug-beating machine made a lot of dust in order to keep the sweeping machine busy. And up in the trees were machines for doing nothing, which not only did nothing, but also helped others with this very hard job. This man here is not Professor Mac One, but Mac Two, his assistant, who's busily sweeping up the squirks. Counting machines? Of course the professor had counting machines. Machines that would count up to 3, 5, and even 9. But a machine that could count up to 10. That was a different kettle of numbers.